Did you know there's now a new second channel exclusively for musical trivia shorts? Trash Theory 2. It's a minute-long additional dose of Trash Theory every week. Subscribe now. Few modern rock bands have had the near immediate success of Wet Leg, earning ungainly comparisons to Pavement, Liz Phair and the B-52s, thanks to their deadpan talk singing. Wet Leg's musical formula was simple: loud guitars, fun times, and not taking yourself too seriously. A welcome change of pace from the dour post-Brexit post-punk surrounding them. Released in the summer of 2021, their buzzy debut single blended innuendo, Mean Girls references, and French furniture to thrilling effect, perhaps even signalling a new dawn for UK rock. This is New British Canon, and this is the story of Chaise Longue. The nucleus of Wet Leg is Rhianne Teasdale and Hester Chambers. Both grew up just off the south coast of England on the isolated Isle of Wight and met when attending the Islands College for a BTEC in music. But the pair wouldn't make music together until much later. They did pursue music separately in the local scene to little fanfare, Teasdale on occasion collaborating with the Plastic Mermaids. And in a piano-led solo guise as Rain. While Chambers played with her boyfriend and future Wet Leg synth player, Josh Mabaraki, in the folky Hester and Red Squirrel. It's not the Midway through 2018, having spent half of her 20s touring on her own, only to play shows to literally no one, Teasdale broke down two songs into a festival set, where the sparse crowd focused more on their food than her music. I started crying hysterically. I'd been playing music for 5 years, just because it becomes so intertwined in your identity. For Teasdale, playing music had just become depressing, so she vowed she would have to quit and get a real job. But with a summer of festival appearances already booked, she roped in Chambers, who was similarly disillusioned, to accompany her on acoustic guitar for the last few shows. It was meant to be one last glorious summer of music, beer, and free entry to festivals, before the real world came a-knocking. But they experienced a joint moment of clarity, thanks to some shouty lads from Bristol. We'd just come out watching Idols at End of the Road, and we were very, very drunk, in a fun way. And we thought it'd be a good idea to come on the Ferris wheel with us. They were like, absolutely not. And we went on anyway. We're going round, and we're really inspired by watching them play this really energetic set. Loud guitars seemed so fun, so we decided to make Wet Leg a thing. As August became September, the pair entered the working world. Chambers at her parents' jewellery shop, and Teasdale moved to London to work as a wardrobe assistant for commercials and music videos. Every pure intention ends when the good times start. But they kept the idea of Wet Leg as a side project. Loud guitars and fun times. Their name helped in their all-nonsense approach to the band. Named after a random pairing of emojis, they would know to never take themselves too seriously. The aim of the game was just to have fun. It doesn't matter if people are judging us. We're just going to do it, because why the hell not? If anything, their motivation was to not pay full price for events like the Isle of Wight Festival, where Wet Leg played their first proper show. Teasdale had only just started learning guitar, and early songs like I Wanna Get Abducted by a UFO were written not to be particularly good, but to get themselves closer to a 30-minute set time. And the band would probably have stayed playing tiny stages at festivals, enjoying themselves, but not being heard. But then 2020 happened. Mommy, Daddy, look at me. I went to school and I got a degree. Teasdale returned to the Isle of Wight for the Christmas period in 2019, where she'd asked Chambers if she could stay around hers for a couple of nights. This couple of nights would end up being 6 weeks, and resulted in their breakthrough single. We went into teenage sleepover mode, watched loads of X-Files and Buffy the Vampire Slayer, and had late night jams. That's where Chaise Longue came from. that big sleepover sesh. The initial kernel of an idea came from what Teasdale was sleeping on for the duration of the sleepover, Hester's chaise longue. As Chambers cooked dinner, Teasdale ate cookies from her uncomfortable, temporary bed, and the pair would spitball lyrics at each other, doubling over laughing with each new addition. Because of this, Chaise Longue embodies that slightly stoned, sleepover atmosphere, as well as a straight rip from Mean Girls.
We're doing a lunchtime survey of new students. Can you answer a few questions?
Okay.
Is your muffin buttered?
What?
Would you like us to assign someone to butter your muffin?
Is your muffin buttered? Would you like us to assign someone to butter your muffin?
There are in-jokes, lashings of innuendo.
I went to school and I got the big D. I got the big D.
And infinite repetitions of the title furniture. It is Teasdale and Chambers' friendship as a song, tied together with their fleeting yet oh so cool vocal back and forth.
Excuse me, what? Excuse me, what?
But parental expectation looms over the song. In her years as a failing musician, Teasdale's parents had been concerned about her future. Dropping out of her A-levels and earning a sole qualification, in music no less, did little to alleviate especially her mother's fears.
Is your mother worried? Would you like us to assign someone to worry your mother?
With her parents strongly suggesting she find a career in accountancy or the Merchant Navy, eventually Teasdale had to give up her dreams for something a bit more stable and a bit more parent reassuring. As such, Chaise Longue's references to her parents are a bit more pointed than on first blush. A, is this what you wanted, mother, cloaked as a joke.
Mommy.
Composed of a drum loop and blaring synth line, a skeletal version of this impromptu jam was quickly recorded with help from Mobaraki, using Logic the same night.
Excuse me. Excuse me.
Music is so funny. It was really late at night, and it was a song that was supposed to be just for us, in a folder called High Jams.
On the chaise lounge, on the chaise lounge, on the chaise lounge, all day long, on the chaise lounge.
And there it was going to stay, travelling no further than the three of them. A joke song for a band that barely existed. Then, a funny thing happened, and everyone's priorities got realigned. From March 2020 onwards, stuck at home with nothing else to do, Teasdale and Chambers doubled down on Wet Leg. Suddenly, me and Hester actually had the time to focus on making music. Wet Leg began as us just pursuing our hobbies, because it was a good way to fill our time. But then we ended up finding a manager in lockdown, signing to Domino Records in lockdown, hitting all of these career milestones in lockdown. Via rough scuzzy demos, including the one for Chaise Longue, they had caught the attention of Domino Records, home of Arctic Monkeys and Franz Ferdinand, but their laid-back attitude almost worked against them, initially not wanting to meet up with the top-tier UK indie label. We were just absolutely silly. We're like, sorry, we don't have time. We're just rolling around in the grass, doing teddy bear rolls with the guitars. Thankfully, the demos were of such quality that Domino pursued a second time, and the band were signed. But like how they had to find enough songs to fill a festival set, now they needed enough for an album. Obviously, when we went to meetings before getting signed, we were like, yes, hello Domino, we'd love to sign for you, and we'd also love to record an album. Even when we said that, and it was discussed, when recording it actually came around, we were like, and then panic sets in. In April 2021, Wet Leg entered the studio with Dan Carey of Black Midi, Squid and Fontaine's DC fame to record their debut album. It was a leap of faith on the label's part. We didn't set out with any theme in mind, because we never thought we'd make an album. When the label asked me about working with Dan Carey, I was like, oh my god, no way, like a basic bitch. Our publishing guys generally thought I was saying no, but I was just in disbelief. Because of the complications of lockdown, the band had not yet released any music and had played a handful of live shows, and those were mostly to friends and family. As such, the songs they had written were completely untested, shaped not by audience reaction and playing them over and over again, but their own whims and desires. This made it so the record contains a spontaneity and fearlessness, all its awkward edges remaining intact. But unlike the new wave of post-punk groups that Carey had produced and were the current vogue of British guitar music, Wet Leg injected their nervy guitar rock with an undeniable sense of fun and humour from the horrors of modern life. Oh No riffs on the infinite scroll of social media. While Too Late Now rips apart the artifice of dating apps.
I don't need no dating app to tell me if I look like crap, to tell me if I'm thin or fat, to tell me should I shave my rat.
I always try to dilute serious things with humour, I think. So it only feels natural if there's a bit of humour in there that would attach itself to something that's maybe a bit sad. It's a very human thing. Supermarket is about doing the big shop while in an altered state. Prompted by desperate local dealers in lockdown, resorting to promotional offers to shift product.
Well, the last time I was picking up, there was buy one, get one free.
Wet Leg's mission statement is good times all the time. So that when the fun stops being fun, you can stop the party, such as on I Don't Want to Go Out. We wanted the songs to be pumped up and a bit fun, but then we're actually just a bunch of emos. We were trying to write party songs, and then actually, we just wrote songs about how we're at a party, and we don't like it. A lot of the album's most cutting lines come from the trilogy of breakup songs. Though you might think comparing a former Paramore to excrement is the worst diss,
like a piece of shale, ever sink or float.
It has to contend with the bitter disappointment of your mum's opening couplet.
When I think about what you've become, I feel sorry for your mum.
They were all inspired by the same aimless, distracting relationship Teasdale broke off to focus on the band. She described it as where you're just plodding along behind someone. It's cool being in love and everything, but it's also cool to feel motivated and put effort into yourself and into your own goals and aspirations. Sometimes when you're so focused on trying to make someone love you, it's a lot of energy that you could be putting into something else. Second single, Wet Dream, was inspired by an unsolicited text from the ex, revealing that he'd had a nighttime fantasy about her, provoking Teasdale's utter disgust.
What makes you think you're good enough to think about me?
Furthering the album's multiple film references, the song has an unexpected nod to Buffalo 66, an obscure Christina Ricci indie film from
1998.
We're not really movie buffs, but we do religiously watch Mean Girls on repeat, Peep Show on repeat, Buffy the Vampire Slayer and X-Files on repeat, oh, and Lord of the Rings on repeat, because that's all you need, isn't it? Wet Leg revealed themselves to the world in June 2021, with the release of Chaise Longue and its accompanying self-directed music video. Partly inspired by the Chats and their similarly low-budget video for Smoko. The pair edited the clip themselves on a free trial version of Final Cut Pro. It took what Teasdale had learnt in her real-life job and ran with it. You can most definitely base a whole music video around wardrobe choices. It's just this little world with us two as these cottagecore characters. It was all kind of accidental. I ordered loads of clothes from the internet, and we tried on some different looks and outfits. We went for the big hats, flaming sunglasses, and pretty dresses, just because we thought it was a funny look. Confusingly, the title piece of furniture does not make an appearance. But despite that apparent misstep, the video quickly went viral on YouTube, to the point that when the band played their first post-lockdown show at the Latitude Festival in July, they packed out their stage's tent. With just little country bumpkins from the Isle of Wight, it was so unexpected that the tent was so rammed. And even more unexpectedly, we had people actually dancing and singing the words to Chaise Longue back at us. It was our first time seeing that people had actually listened to it, and we'd been in the tiniest little bubble world. It didn't really compute initially. It still doesn't really. While the song never charted beyond number 74 on the UK singles chart, it would soon become inescapable in indie rock circles, and the soundtrack to many post-lockdown get-togethers. Old guard like Elton John, Iggy Pop, and Dave Grohl couldn't wait to lay praise at Wet Leg's feet. Pearl Jam even covering the track live in a medley with Daughter. They would also gain their fair share of prestigious festival appearances and gradually ballooning opening tours. Alongside the band that gave them that initial spark, Idols, there was Foles, Florence and the Machine, Harry Styles, and Churches. Said Lauren Mabry from Churches, "It's rare to find a band that, from the off, sounds unique, individual, and identifiable. Lyrically, they can be wry, but their music feels very honest and joyful. I also think it's rare for women to be allowed to have a sense of humour in their music, which is just another thing to love about them." Chaise Longue would reach number 3 on the NME's end of year song list, while hitting number 2 on NPR's similar ranking. But that doesn't mean they haven't received criticism, even if it's mostly from randoms in YouTube comments.
Just like stupid comments on the internet. Like, for example, I am like, just not using my guitar, and then like I need to play it in the chorus or something. There will like always be a comment being like, girls shouldn't play guitar, women shouldn't play guitar. And it's just like, it's so dated, but it's still there. And I just hate it so much, and it's so frustrating. And I just wish like Sam Session Guitarist 54 would just shut up.
Wet Leg's self-titled album was finally released in April 2022. A year after it was recorded. It went number 1 in the UK album chart, number 14 on Billboard, and was ranked in the top 10 best albums of 2022 by numerous publications. Then came the awards. As well as being nominated for the Mercury Prize, Wet Leg won 2 Grammys and 2 Brit Awards. On stage to accept their Brit for Best New Artist, Teasdale quoted Wholesale, the speech that Alex Turner of Arctic Monkeys had given 9 years previous.
"That rock and roll, eh? That rock and roll, it just won't go away. Might hibernate from time to time and sink back into the swamp."
"That rock and roll, hey? That rock and roll, it just won't go away. It might hibernate from time to time and sink back into the swamp."
Highlighting the unkillable nature of British rock music. Already, Wet Leg are inspiring others, alongside big name covers of their work.
"I was in your wet dream, driving in the car, saw you at the side of the road."
The emerging generation is holding them up as role models, showing that a guitar band can still be culturally relevant. Said Allegra Weingarten of Mama. "I love seeing people so stoked on a band. What Wet Leg do, what Nirvana did, what Mama are aiming for. It all stems from the communal idea of a band. In present year, the idea of the band is sadly becoming somewhat outdated. Through new technology and social media, releasing music solo seems more tempting than ever to new musicians. But Wet Leg becoming one of the most talked about acts in the last year proves that the rock and roll band isn't dead yet. The irony is that they established themselves at a point in history where everyone was at the most isolated and disconnected. Wet Leg came together through the power of friendship to rock out, have a good time, and butter your muffin. Only time will tell if they're the next Nirvana or merely a damp limb." Thanks for watching. If you like this video, like, subscribe, And why don't you also do me a favour and share it with a couple of people? It really does help. Also check out the second channel. The link is on screen and in the description. And as always, I'd like to shout out my supporters over on Patreon. Thank you so very much. And I'll see you in 2 weeks' time for something quiet, then loud.